So because of that, because of the shielding, that outermost electron is loosely bounded, and so it will increase the atomic size also, right? Whereas in case of fluorine, the effective nuclear charge is more as compared to lithium. Fluorine is having more effective nuclear charge, which will overcome the shielding. It will try to hold the outermost electron more closely toward nucleus. So that is why the atomic radius is decreasing when we are moving from left to right in a period. Right? Now, when we are moving top to bottom in a group, then in that case, what happens is that after every period, principal quantum number is increasing, shell is increasing. So when shell is increasing, then the shielding of electron is more, right? जो इलेक्ट्रॉन है वो जो न्यूक्लियर चार्ज है, जो न्यूक्लियस का जो चार्ज है पॉजिटिव टू नेगेटिव जो अट्रैक्शन है, उसको शील्ड करते हैं, सो दैट द आउटरमोस्ट इलेक्ट्रॉन जो है, या जो एक सेल से दूसरे सेल में जब इलेक्ट्रॉन होते हैं तो उसमें जो इफेक्टिव न्यूक्लियर चार्ज है वो लेस हो जाता है, वो इतना इफेक्टिव नहीं रह पाता, जिसके कारण जो है, जो जैसे जैसे आपका शेल इंक्रीज हो रहा है वैसे वैसे जो है उसका साइज जो है वो इंक्रीज होता चला जाता है, राइट? दो व्हेन वी आर मूविंग फ्रॉम टॉप टू बॉटम, तो इफेक्टिव न्यूक्लियर चार्ज इंक्रीज हो रहा है, राइट? लेकिन जो शील्डिंग है वो भी उतनी स्ट्रॉन्ग होती जा रही है, बिकॉज दैट सेल इज इंक्रीजिंग, राइट? ड्यू टू दैट द शील्डिंग, इन दिस केस द शील्डिंग ऑफ न्यूक्लियर चार्ज, दे ओवरकम द इफेक्टिव न्यूक्लियर चार्ज. सो दैट इज वाई this atomic radius, it increases when we are moving from top to bottom in a group, right? Understood? Now this is graphical representation of how when we are moving from left to right in a period, lithium highest, fluorine lowest, right? But when we are moving top to bottom, then lithium lowest, cesium more, fluorine lowest, iodine most, right? So it is increasing, right? Now ionic radius, what do you mean by ionic radius? Actually the radius of an ion is known as ionic radius, right? There are two type of ion, cation and anion. We will discuss with cation. Just a minute. Yes, we will discuss with cation first. Cation is actually when an element loses its electron, it is called cation. Now when an element or an atom loses its electron, then in this case effective nuclear charge increases, right? Because here, suppose we will take a case of sodium, right? 11 atomic number, Na plus electron. Now in this case of Na plus, it have 11 proton plus and 10 electron. So if we compare, then effective nuclear charge is more on 10 electron, right? Because here one proton is extra, right? So in this case, ionic radius of cation is less than atomic radius of atom, neutral atom, right? Now in case of anion, anion means taking one electron, it will have a negative, right? Say fluorine have taken one electron and become one minus, right? Here we know the fluorine atomic number is 9. So here in this case, fluorine minus, it will have 9 proton and 10 electron, right? So here the effective nuclear charge is decreasing. Effective nuclear charge decreases, right, on electron, right? So in this case, ionic radius of anion is greater than atomic radius of neutral atom. Okay, understood, right? Okay, now moving further. Yes, here moving further, here they are giving ionic radius of fluorine ion is 136 picometer, whereas atomic radius of fluorine is 64 picometer. See, the ion atomic radius is almost double, right? More than double even, right? And on the other hand, the atomic radius of sodium is 186 picometer compared to ionic radius of sodium ion is 95 picometer. So here the cation ionic radius is decreasing, whereas anion ionic radius is increasing, right? Now isoelectronic species, they are known as those ion which are having same number of electron, like O2 minus means oxygen have taken 2 electron, right? So its electron become 10, right? Fluorine taken 1 electron, so its electron become 10. Sodium losing 1 electron, so its electron become 10. Magnesium losing 2 electron, so its electrons become 10. So these are the isoelectronic species whose electrons are same, right? Ions with greater negative charge will have the larger radius, right? Due to net repulsion of electron with overweight of nuclear charge with ion will expand its size, right? I explained you about the nuclear charge, effective nuclear charge on ion and cation, right? Now ionization enthalpy. What is ionization enthalpy? This is a new term. This ionization enthalpy is a quantitative measure of the tendency of an element to lose electron is given its ionization enthalpy, right? The tendency of an electron of an atom to lose electron is ionization enthalpy, right? Or it will be measured in the amount of heat required to remove an electron. It represents the energy required to remove an electron from an isolated gaseous atom X in its ground state. Right? Okay? So, the amount of energy required to lose one electron is called the first ionization enthalpy. Right? It is called as first ionization enthalpy. Now, the amount of energy required to lose second electron is called the second ionization enthalpy. Right? Here. The ionization enthalpy is expressed in kilojoule per mole. Right? It is expressed in kilojoule per mole. Right? We can define the second ionization enthalpy as the energy required to remove the second most loosely bounded electron. It is the energy required to carry out the reaction shown in equation 3.2. This one. Right? Okay. Now, ionization enthalpies are always positive. Means they have to be provided some energy. Energy हमें जो है एक energy जो है हमें लगानी पड़ेगी to get that electron out. Right? To get the electron out. Right? So, this ionization enthalpy is always positive. It is always positive. Right? Now, ionization enthalpy is it vary from left to right. How? See, left mein kya hai aapke? Left mein lithium hai, alkyl metals hai, jin mein ek valence electron ek hai, one electron hai, that is loosely bound. So they are ready to lose one electron to achieve noble gas configuration. Right? So their ionization enthalpy is less. Ionization enthalpy is less because it is they are their outermost electron is loosely bounded. Second thing, because of as I explained you earlier, lithium and sodium case, that they are having noble gas electronic configuration, then plus one. Right, then plus one, right? So the noble gas configuration, because their last outermost shell is fully filled, and then after that one electron is there in the next shell, valence shell. So in that case, the shielding of nuclear charge is more. The shielding of nuclear charge is more, so they can lose one electron more easily. So that is why the ionization enthalpy is least, सबसे कम जो है वो group first की होगी. और जैसे जैसे हम जो है left to right जाते जाएंगे, वैसे वैसे ionization enthalpy increase होती जाएगी. Right? Because जैसे जैसे हम left to right जाते जाएंगे तो जो effective nuclear charge है वो भी बढ़ता जाएगा, और वो जो है वो shielding को overpower कर देगा. जो shield electron जो shielding है, जो nuclear charge को outermost shell तक नहीं पहुंचने दे रहा, ठीक है, उसको overpower कर जाता है आपका nuclear charge. क्योंकि जैसे जैसे हम left to right जा रहे हैं, वैसे वैसे nuclear charge increase हो रहा है. Right? So that is why lithium having lowest ionization enthalpy, whereas neon or fluorine having highest. Neon even noble gas always have the highest, but fluorine having highest ionization enthalpy, right? Because fluorine atom से जो है एक electron निकालना बहुत मुश्किल है as compared to lithium, right? You will see 520 kilojoule per mole, whereas in fluorine it is 1681 kilojoule per month per mole. Sorry, so it means it is more than thrice, right? More than thrice. But when we move from top to bottom, in that case, same shell is increasing. So when shell is increasing, though nuclear charge is also increasing, but when shell is increasing, then shielding is more. So effective nuclear charge on the outermost loosely bound electron is less, right? So due to that, they will lose more easily electron as compared to upper group electron, upper period atoms, right? Like in lithium having the highest in its group, whereas Cs, cesium having the lowest, right? Okay, understood? I mentioned enthalpy now. Ionization enthalpy will be higher than the first, the second ionization enthalpy will be higher than the first ionization enthalpy because it is more difficult to remove an electron from a positive charge ion than a neutral atom, right? It is because positive charge ion mein jo hai, jo effective nuclear charge hai, wo badh jata hai as compared to neutral atom, right? So same in the same way, third ionization enthalpy will be higher than the second and so on, right? You will find maximum ionization enthalpy maximum at noble gas because they are having closed electron shell, their outermost shell is fulfilled. So that's why they are more tightly packed as compared to others. So it is difficult to take electron from that configuration, right? The lower the ionization enthalpy here, lower ionization enthalpy means higher reactive in terms of metallic character, right? So lithium is more reactive than barium, right? Okay, but not I'm saying about metallic character, right? Not non-metallic character. Metallic character means losing electron. Whatever I explained, it was there in this is the same. They were explaining this thing, right? Now there is a special case here you will see this is the graph of atomic number and here is the ionization enthalpy, right? This is the hydrogen, then helium most, then lithium the least, then after that they keep on increasing, it moves to neon highest, then again sodium least, then again move argon, then again potassium least, right? Like that they are showing till 60 atomic numbers, right? Okay, now take the case of two, boron and beryllium. Boron, actually the answer lies in the electronic configuration. Everything lies in the electronic configuration. Boron, Z is equal to 5, that will be 1s2, 2s2, 2p1, right? Understood? Whereas beryllium, Z is equal to 4, so 1s2, 2s2, right? So in this case, though boron is having more effective nuclear charge as compared to beryllium, because beryllium is having 4 electron and 4 proton, whereas boron have 5 electron, 5 proton. So here in this case effective charge is more, but you will see that in boron outermost electron is on p, right? Whereas in beryllium outermost electron is in s, S sub cell. S sub cell is more close as compared to P. S sub cell is more close as compared to P. So here, this 2S, it will shield the nuclear charge. ये जो है न्यूक्लियर चार्ज जो है वो 2P तक पहुंचने नहीं देता, कम पहुंचने देता है, शील्डिंग करता है, शील्ड करता है न्यूक्लियर चार्ज की. तो P तक जो है, P में जो इलेक्ट्रॉन है, ये वन इलेक्ट्रॉन, दैट इज मोर लूजली बाउंड देन एज कंपेयर टू इन बेरिलियम. सो इट विल लूज मोर इजिली. सो द आयोनाइजेशन एंथैल्पी ऑफ बोरोन इज स्लाइटली लेस देन बेरिलियम. You'll see helium, lithium, then this is beryllium. Boron, you'll see boron or beryllium ke beech mein boron ki enthalpy is slightly less, right, due to that shielding, right, then again it increases. So that is the reason which I explained you why it is less, right. Now electron gain enthalpy. This electron gain enthalpy is the energy required either lose or gain when an electron is gained by the atom, right? Means if X is there, then gaseous atom, then when it become anion, so the energy used, that energy will be positive, that will be negative, right? Anything, it can be positive or negative, right? It can be endothermic or exothermic, right? Agar energy release ho rahi hai, agar any energy release ho rahi hai, then it will be considered as negative. Theek hai? Agar energy gain ho rahi hai, then it will be considered as positive, right? Here in ionization enthalpy, energy is used, right? हम energy लगा रहे हैं, right? System is using energy to extract the electron from the outermost shell. So we are, this is an endothermic. हम energy हम provide कर रहे हैं. So here it is positive, right? But here in this case, एनर्जी कैन बी रिलीज ऑल्सो, एनर्जी रिलीज भी होती है व्हेन इलेक्ट्रॉन इज गेन, व्हेन इलेक्ट्रॉन इज गेन देन एनर्जी रिलीज इज ऑल्सो, राइट. सो दैट इज व्हाई इट इज नेगेटिव, राइट. नाउ यू नो दैट ऑल द मेटल दे आर हैविंग टेंडेंसी टू गेन, टू लूज इलेक्ट्रॉन, राइट, एंड नॉन मेटल आर हैविंग टेंडेंसी टू गेन इलेक्ट्रॉन. फ्लोरीन की टेंडेंसी क्या है? इलेक्ट्रॉन गेन करने की, राइट. वेयर एज लिथियम की टेंडेंसी क्या है? इलेक्ट्रॉन लूज करने की. तो अगर लिथियम को अगर हम एक इलेक्ट्रॉन और दे दें एक्स्ट्रा, राइट, इन दैट केस वी हैव टू गिव एनर्जी, हमें एनर्जी लगानी पड़ेगी, हमें एनर्जी देनी पड़ेगी उसको, राइट. बट इन केस ऑफ फ्लोरीन इट इज he will take electron and he will give energy, right. So that is why electron gain enthalpies, they are negative. Like fluorine jo hai wo minus 328 means he have releases energy and gain electron, right. He have released energy and gain electron. So it when by gaining electron, it reaches into noble gas configuration, so it loses energy, right. So electron gain enthalpy is very high negative. Electron gain enthalpy will be there of your halogens, whereas alkyl it is very less negative enthalpy will be there, right. Now for this noble gas, these are all positive electron gain enthalpy, right? Because they are noble gas elements, right? They don't need any electron, right? So, but to give them electron, we have to supply some energy. We have to supply some energy, right? Okay. This is all about electron gain enthalpy. When an electron is added to a neutral gaseous atom X to convert it into negative ion, the enthalpy change, means the energy change, accompanying the process is defined as electron gain enthalpy, delta EGH, right? This one. Okay. Now, electronegativity. Electronegativity is the tendency of an atom. Tendency of an atom in a covalent compound or chemical compound, actually covalent compound, to attract the shared electron toward itself. Because covalent compound mein kya hota hai, this is one electron, this is another electron, so he shared one electron, so these both the electron were shared by one by x, one by y, so he will also use this electron, x will also use this electron to complete its octet, right? In this case, these shared electron, they will not remain in the center. They might shift it toward y or might shift toward x depending upon electron negativity. If x is more electron negative, then this shared electron, they will shift it toward x. If y is more electron negative, then this shared electron shifted toward y. Okay, so this is called electron negativity. And electron negativity, it increases from left to right. It increases from left to right, right, in a period, and in a group it decreases. In a period it decreases from top to bottom, right? So this is all about your some of the properties. This figure 3.7, these are showing. This is a periodic table. Non-metallic character increases when it is moving from left to right and top to bottom, right? Non-metallic character increases from left to right in a period, and it increases from down to top. Metallic character, it increases from right to left and top to bottom, right? Electron gain enthalpy, left side is more negative electron gain enthalpy as compared to right side, it is more negative gain enthalpy, whereas compared to left side. Ionization enthalpy, it is more difficult to extract electron from halogens as compared to alkyl, right? Now atomic size is increasing top to bottom, and atomic size is decreasing from left to right, right? Then electronegativity, it is increasing from left to right and decreasing from top to bottom, right? So these are all representation of different properties which vary from left to right in period and top to bottom in a group, right? If you have not understood anything about that, then you'll let me know. I will explain further, or there will be a doubt class, right? In that also I will explain you about your doubts. But in next chapter we will in next lecture we will discuss about the oxidation state valency, then anomalous property of second period elements, periodic trend and chemical reactivity, and then with that your chapter is over, right? These all properties, characteristics are based on few things. First thing is their electronic configuration. In electron configuration, how much electrons are there in valence electron, which will tell the how it is closely packed or loosely bounded. Second thing, their effective nuclear charge, right? Third thing, their shielding of a nuclear charge to outer most shell. Then there is a electron to electron repulsion is also there, right? So these are few factors which will tells the different properties of different elements. Okay students, from next lecture we will complete this chapter, and then there will be some exercise part, and then our doubt class, then we will start with another new chapter, right? Okay, thank you student.